What a great day for the city of Shreveport. We're here with our annual 23rd annual Martin Luther King basketball tournament. We have close to 70 teams this year from over five states here in the South. And our fundamental purpose is just to get youth, adults all together one weekend for fun, fitness, and play basketball and use the sport of basketball as a venue to unite people together.
I think that the MLK tournament is very important because it shows that Martin Luther King's dream is alive. Right now we have citizens all over Shreveport, white, black, and every other color, coming together to celebrate in his idea, his dream.
Brings people from all walks of life. I was talking to a lady earlier, she was from East Texas. She came over to support her nephew, and that's the great thing about it. You get to see the parents and the grandparents come out to see their kids do something positive. And that's how it brings the community together, because if you see the stands in there, you got everybody in there. And when you leave, there's really no loser. You know, they're a little sad, but the kids have a great time.
This event is so unique because it's inclusive. We have a therapeutic wheelchair division. We have a youth division. We have an adult division. And it's free. So what a great weekend for the city of Shreveport, and we're just glad to be a part of it.
At Southern Hills, we have the middle school age bracket, and so I think it's about 12 to 14 teams in that age group. And then over here at MJ Moore, you have the 10 and under age group. I think it's about 8 to 10 teams in that age group, which the kids are coming out and having a good time. The brackets are real steep. You know, some of the kids are, you know, they're used to playing against each other, but it gives them a chance to play on other teams and have a little competition going on against, you know, other rivalries. So the competition is very high, you know, and all the kids love to come out. The parents love to come out. It's a big thing for the city, you know, and my kids love it. They look forward to it.
It teaches me how to do teamwork, and I've been playing for this team for 2 seasons.
I've been playing for 3 seasons. I like it because I wanted to follow my sister. She was a basketball player. She's 17 now, so I want to follow her footsteps.
I look forward to going to the championship and winning the trophy, and this is my second time being in the tournament.
My favorite part about basketball is shooting, shooting, dribbling, and doing teamwork.
Training that goes into it, you really have to train good, because got certain kids that play on different teams and they're already being trained, because some of them play, like I said, the middle school tournament, so they're on certain middle school teams, and you have to get your teams together and get the chemistry going. So, and some of the kids are up, have a little ups on some of the other kids, because they already in the, you know, they're playing together, so, you know, their chemistry is a little bit better. So it's real good. I travel all over with my teams, you know, AAU, and this tournament is different because it's my home, you know, so I have to support it. So it's a real good tournament, and we just have to come out and support it. You know, we need more things like this going on in the city for the kids. Keep them out of trouble, keep them busy, you know.
Well, I came out here to support my son. He plays for the Shreveport Gators, and they played yesterday. They played 4 games. They lost one. And then today we played 3 games, which was back-to-back, so our boys are exhausted. So we're very excited that they even made it to the championship, just because we know that they are very tired and they have been working very, very hard. He's been playing basketball since he was 5, so this is his love. He loves it. He says he's going to go to the NBA.
I like basketball because it's fun, and I've always been playing basketball since I was little.
I love basketball. I've been playing since I was like in 4th grade. Because I started playing, and then I just love it, and I play every day.
I've been playing since I was 5 years old. Now I'm 14. I'm in the 7th grade, and I love the basketball because, like, I see, like, people on TV that want to be like, they want to grow up and everything. So I just made basketball, like, my life and then my career. So when I grow up, I will be an NBA basketball player.
Basketball in my life is like I'm representing my family, and you should always show a good impression to everyone.
Why is basketball so important to you?
Because I get to play in SPAR, and I get to play with all my friends that I've been playing with since I was 7 years old.
And how has this tournament been for you?
It's been good because we represent Dr. Martin Luther King, his dream, and we all have a big dream one day that we'll be in NBA or NFL.
And what's your favorite thing about basketball?
That you can spend time with your teammates.
Well, I just say thank God because I'm living today. And Martin Luther King, the tournament is for the children and everything.
I think it's a time for people to actually get to appreciate the athletes that we have here. Different sports throughout the year, you know, football, basketball, and we also got softballs.
My husband and I both support him. My husband is also helping the coach the boys, but we're at every practice and every game. And I think it's very important that you support your kids and know, you know, let them know that, you know, what they're doing is important to you. And it's not just always about what parents are doing and what you have going on, but it's important about, you know, what they have going on, you know, and you have to support them. You know, if they don't have people out there hollering for them and screaming for them, I'm, you know, I've lost my voice because I've been hollering since yesterday. But I mean, to me, this is like one of the proudest moments, like just being here for him and just, you know that he's out there playing his heart out.
Well, one thing that athletics does is bring people together from all ages, from all genders, from all races, and we've been using this tournament for over 23 years to do that. We have teams from Mississippi, from Georgia, from Texas, from Louisiana, and it's more of a family atmosphere here, and we have enjoyed hosting this tournament for the 23rd season. We're using this tournament also as a fitness awareness campaign to get people out, to get people active.
Staying active is a way of life that'll keep you healthy. So I think that athletics should be a part of everyday life for everyone to keep themselves healthy.
It's so important that kids everywhere get the word that, you know, games are fun, you know, inside, but get outside and do something that involves running and using your muscles.
Show people how important athletics is, or parks and recreation departments are to their respective communities, and our staff have done a great job of doing that this year.
We're here to service the citizens of Shreveport. We have several sports that we offer to the community. The major sports that we offer is softball, baseball, basketball, and we have a very large youth football program. In those events, we also do have programs for our adults also.
We're more than just recreation, we're more than just athletics. We provide services for all of our citizens, leisure services that is, and we would love for you all to go to our website and see what we have to offer here in Shreveport.
Also, we get involved in the community as well. We take them to nursing homes, we take them to jails to let them talk to the, you know, jailers and so on and so on.
This tournament is all about the community. And when we talk about the community, we're talking about the city of Shreveport, the youth, our citizens that participate, as well as our parents. And we can't do events like this without the community support, especially our parents. They're giving up their weekends coaching and volunteering and traveling. And when these type of events come to Shreveport, it's just a win-win situation for everybody.
We got Reach for the Stars mentoring program, which is a great program. They will be with us also set up. So we're going to have several different vendors over there that's going to be giving out a lot of great information to the community. We're going to have safety, child safety, and you're going to have yours truly, SPAR. We'll be there telling you about all the free programs that we have to offer to the community, just to name a few. We have a after-school program for the youth, after-school program for the teens. We have a super senior program. We have a therapeutic program, which Superintendent Jermaine Williams will cover with you a little bit later. Also at Southern University, we're going to have two bounce houses for the children to come out and enjoy themselves. So it's going to be a fun-filled day. SPAR is all about community. It's all about family. It's all about service. In other words, we service the community as a whole. We provide them meaning for programs. Like, for example, like I say, for seniors, we have a great senior program Monday through Friday from 9 to 1. The seniors go on field trips. They play bingo. They have a lot of fun games and that sort of thing.
We have excellent food out here, but more importantly, we have the people of Shreveport. We're all coming together with SPAR being the catalyst to kick all these things off. This, like, again, I'm going to be redundant. This is the 23rd year, and we're all extremely excited about it.
We have our SPAR Citywide Canned Food Drive that will be going on. Our goal is 2,500. Now, we hadn't reached the goal. We didn't reach the goal last year. We're hoping to reach it this year. And so we have it. We got 15 community centers in the city of Shreveport. So we are accepting donations at all 15 centers. And it goes to the North Louisiana Food Bank to help out the needy here in this community.
people with disabilities would like for individuals in the community to know that they are capable of doing everything that able-bodied individuals can do as well.
We started the program 3 years ago. We're still just learning. Some of the kids have been with us for 3 years, and some of them have been just with us for a couple of days.
Most of these kids are Caddo Parish School kids. They're all adapted PE kids, and we try to integrate the program of our adaptive physical education into the sports that we do. These are, you know, a little higher level kids sometimes. We've got a variety of levels on this team. We've got a developmental level, and then we've got some kids that really have some athletic ability. This is the first time I've actually come and coached this. I used to coach high school basketball, but I never did the basketball with wheelchairs. I've done the disabled sports, but they're a bunch of great kids. They played real hard today. It was, you know, pretty demanding on them to play for four straight hours almost, but they're all good kids, and they've improved a lot.
This is a wonderful opportunity that we partnership with Caddo Parish School Board System. Ms. Diana Gates, physical therapist, and Bill Samuels, that's over the Adaptive PE program. We have collaborated and formed an Adapted Committee as well for persons with disabilities, and we want the word to be out there.
These kids can do just the same as other kids. They like to get out and, you know, be supported by others. They have a great time.
We do have Caddo Parish kids, but it's open to kids from any of the outlying areas, too. They can come Thursday nights. We're at the SPAR has supported us and been great. We are there every week through mid-March. We'll be there.
How long have you been playing basketball for?
2 years.
And what's your favorite part?
Well, catching and throwing the ball and try to have a good time.
Fastness and the baskets. And on defense, you get to, like, guard them and stuff. That's what's fun.
It helps in like build on how to teach other disability kids and what you can do in life and how you can be successful.
I want them. We have fun.
Working with the disability teams is very exciting and challenging. They are very, very competitive. They really enjoy the sport, and they enjoy just being able to teach other individuals that they are capable of doing things even though they have a disability.
You know, we have different clinics that we put out there throughout the year, basketball clinics, tennis clinics, all kinds of softball clinics and everything. So we try to market and put different activities, different sports out there for individuals that have interests that they can come out and experience those skill-building moments. And if they like it, we hope to kind of join them with our teams. The team that I worked with really showed me that willpower and dedication, you can achieve anything. Just to see their drive to be the best that they can be. And if they can't make that shot the first time, they try even harder to make it the next time. And just working together as a team makes me realize that we all are connected. We all have a job to do to kind of help each other out, even in all walks of life. They are really encouraging to me because We all have our own individual limitations and we have things that we have to overcome ourselves in life. And they have proved to me that anything is possible if you put your mind to it.
For a lot of people to come out and watch and see us raise wheelchair awareness, wheelchair sports, I think it's a great opportunity for everybody, not just the players. Everything you see out there that those guys are doing, able bodies at their practices, we're doing the same thing, but just we're pushing. So it's sometimes we think it's a lot more intense, but it is what it is, you know.
Why are you here today?
Because I'm seeing my cousin play, and I just wanted to come see him play, how people in wheelchair play basketball. This is my first one because I didn't know that they played wheelchair basketball, and so this is my first time seeing one.
I live in Shreveport. I came here, actually I worked the tournament yesterday, and I was just curious to see who would win. We've got some good contenders here from both in-state and out-of-state. Both of the teams playing today are from out-of-state, but I'm here to see who won. I see some good basketball.
It brings actually not just the players together, it brings also the families together. So anybody who has a family member or a friend or a cousin or anything in a wheelchair, they actually get to come out and support, because we always support our friends' able bodies on the course. So it's fun. It brings everybody together. So, and it gives a different aspect to everybody who plays sports, because people hear about it but never really see it. But I think now that they see it, they think a little bit more about it.
I hope for the Shreveport team to actually grow. We're just starting out for the first time as a team representing SPAR. I got a chance to work with a bunch of great guys who actually know the game and work well together. We're looking to expand in number and also go to more tournaments to get more experience. The more tournaments that you win in these kind of tournaments, you actually gain a better chance of going to a national level. Also, we have different classes of each athlete. So each class is broken down into four different classes, and on a scale of whatever individual disabilities they may have. Some are in chairs that actually can get out and move around, and some are kind of confined to those chairs, and we classify those on different levels. So there are different skill levels out there on the court, and they play as a team with an equal advantage.
We're a new team, so us playing together, and actually the last few tournaments haven't gone as well as we planned. We've actually been hitting it really, really hard the last couple months, and today we actually played as a team and beat a really good team. They've beaten us a couple of times already, so it felt good to beat them.
This is an annual tournament. Feel free to call our athletic department at any time at 318-673-7748, or go to our website at www.myspar.org.
We came out to watch the athletics that are in action, all the final events. Our kids are having a lot of fun watching the athletes that are playing basketball, and our kids are also going to be performing during the halftime and jumping rope, and we have a lot of national champions, international champions, and we think we're going to show the crowd something that maybe is unique for athletics, and something that the kids do that maybe everyone doesn't see every day.
And tell me a little bit about the halftime show. What can we expect?
Well, you're going to see a lot of gymnastics. You're going to see a lot of athleticism. Most people, when they think of jump rope, they think of people just skipping rope or maybe a little double dutch. And I think everyone's going to be amazed at the choreography and the intricacies of what our athletes do while they're jumping rope. Right now, we're in our season where we're getting ready for regional and national competitions. And so there may be some previews of some things they're going to be doing, getting ready for the national competition as well as the Junior Olympics.
We are just celebrating Black History Month and the anniversary of the 23rd anniversary of what? The basketball tournament here in Shreveport.
This was the Martin Luther King essay contest, and they opened this up to all the kids across Shreveport-Bossier, and these two young men, Xavier and Ladarian, were the winners of this excellent contest. We felt so good about this because it allowed them to look at the past history of great leaders and to try to emulate their lives.
The contest was about the most influential African-American that you thought who it was, and I chose Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. because he is my favorite African-American.
The reason I wrote about Nelson Mandela because he went to jail for other people's rights.
This is Black History Month, and we want to encourage other students to get involved, to find those leaders who they look up to, and to write essays, and just to study about people, great people of the past.
We're celebrating Black History Month, that's one. We're also celebrating one of the iconic figures in the United States, which is Martin Luther King. But more important, it's an opportunity for Shreveport to get together as one community, one day at a time, and build communion individually by playing a little basketball.
We always want more teams. We have close to 80 teams here this weekend. We always want more teams involved. Anytime we can get more citizens in the community involved, it's always a plus for us. But we're happy with the success of this tournament. I think our teams are happy, our coaches are happy, our volunteers are happy, our parents are happy, and the administration with the city of Shreveport is happy with what we're doing.
We bring in together different ethnic backgrounds, different disabilities, different youth, men and women teams that come together in unity to celebrate Dr. Martin Luther King, the 23rd basketball tournament.
We'd like to thank all of our sponsors, most definitely our Cumulus, Chesapeake Energy, and Academy Sports. These are our presenting sponsors that have done a great job this year supporting our developmental cause for this tournament.
Yes, the vendors are really, really a key part of our tournament. We have many vendors that sponsor us every year. We have Music Mountain Waters that sponsor us, Domino's Pizza, that Domino's is very supportive every year, and we have many more. Cumulus Broadcasting Station, Walmart, so that's just quite a few I would like to name.
We've been involved with this tournament for about 3 years, and on Championship Sunday, we have our air talents come out and play music and do the halftime entertainment, and it's just Cumulus likes to be community involved, and this is a great way for the kids and to have something to do to keep them out of trouble, and so it was a great partnership between the city of Shreveport, SPAR, and Cumulus Broadcasting.
It just doesn't start with this tournament, you know, it starts with getting the kids involved early in age with the SPAR. You know, I have kids that are 14, 15, 16 now that started in SPAR when they was like 3 or 4, so you have to get them involved, you have to get them out, you know, you have to get out the house, get them off that PlayStation and Xbox, you know, you got to get them in, you know, you got to get them putting in work, you know. Keep them in school and doing good homework and get them out here and let them do some practice.
I played all year because I work hard to success and like make get buckets and everything defense-wise.
We'll do this again next year, and we're always involved in areas in which we operate, and look out in your communities. Chesapeake is out there doing great things.
We bring a whole host of different events for the kids, and I mean, nothing more than basketball to bring the kids together, you know, something they love.
I would say that there's a lot of good basketball here in Shreveport. It's a great central location so that people from everywhere don't have to travel too far. But we've got some good teams playing here. And then also we have some good attractions to bring people to Shreveport.
They love that it's really a family-friendly event and that there are people out watching the athletes and supporting the athletes, and that even if it's not an event you're involved in, that everyone is still supportive of one another. So it's been a great experience for the kids.
The athletics builds communities. Athletics is one entity that can build a community, because all the barriers are broken. You know, the gender, the race, the young and the old. When you talk about an athletic event, you're talking about bringing people together. And that's what Martin Luther King was about, and that's what this event is about also.